State Department Inspector General said today the government's official investigation of the Benghazi terror attacks was not biased. Republicans have said the review was not independent. Meanwhile, we have a Fox News exclusive tonight about missing weapons falling into the hands of terrorists in that volatile region. Here's correspondent Adam Housley.
Brett, the size and scope of the weapons stolen so far is worse than we previously reported, and some of it is now in the hands of militia groups aligned with terrorist organizations and the Muslim Brotherhood. The equipment was signed over by the U.S. State Department and used to train Libyans outside of Tripoli by U.S. Special Forces. The training team, funded by the U.S. Department of Defense, has since been pulled, partly in response to overnight raids last month that resulted in the military equipment being stolen. According to diplomats, multiple State Department and military sources, dozens of up-armored vehicles called GMVs are now missing. Basically, they're a highly armored Humvee with various sets of weapon mounts and can be outfitted with smoke grenade launchers. Now, along with the GMVs, hundreds of weapons are now missing also, including Glock pistols, M4 rifles, and the most disturbing to our sources, possibly every single set of night vision equipment is gone. This is advanced technology that is infrared both day and night and gives the U.S. an advantage.
This is a big deal anytime you talk about, you know, pilfering of U.S. weaponry by militias or groups that don't have our interests at heart. And it's not the first time it's happened. It probably won't be the last because we don't seem to learn from past examples.
Diplomatic sources also tell us they're seeing a recipe of the 9/11 Benghazi attack now brewing in Tripoli and across the rest of Libya, and they worry that American and Western convoys will be attacked using these stolen weapons and vehicles. The current Libyan government is also threatened. Meantime, special operators tell Fox News that camps throughout eastern Libya continue to train terrorists, and border controls around the country are also non-existent in most areas. They worry that the theft of these weapons and the open borders are feeding Al-Qaeda and the Muslim Brotherhood, threatening Libya's neighbors as well. Brett.
Adam Housley in Los Angeles. Adam, thank you. The U.S. has signed a global arms trade treaty, which gun activists say is a violation of the Second Amendment. It will face a very tough road in the U.S. Senate. Secretary of State John Kerry signed the pact today and called it a significant step in keeping the world safe.
We would never think about supporting a treaty that is inconsistent with the rights of Americans, the rights of American citizens, to be able to exercise their guaranteed rights under our Constitution.
The NRA maintains the treaty is just the latest attack on gun rights. Quote, the Obama administration is once again demonstrating its contempt for our fundamental individual right to keep and bear arms.